bucur să fiu la această întâlnire organizată de către Asociația de Podiatrie și voi susține cele câteva cuvinte în limba engleză, dat fiindcă urmează secțiunea de discuții la care vor participa și invitații noștri străini. So, for today I prepare only some thoughts on what is therapeutic patient education, the COVID-19 context and the necessity to continue to prevent amputations and of course ulcerations. As we all know, therapeutic patient education or diabetes self-management education as it is called in US means not only to deliver information but also to provide the persons with diabetes with skills, abilities to take care of their feet in this more specific context, and also and the final scope is to change their behavior towards a more preventive attitude regarding diabetic feet in general. And the role of therapeutic patient education to prevent ulceration is well accepted by everybody. The question is only how long such a diabetes education program for diabetic foot should be, how frequent should we make, let's say, revisions of our patients' knowledge and skills. And this may be the main reason why clinical trials didn't yet demonstrate it very clearly, the role of patient education. How can we do it? In most of the situations, at least in Romania, we deliver some elements of diabetic foot education in the more general context of education for diabetes. And this may be a disadvantage because usually when you deliver a lot of information, sometimes in a small amount of time, the importance of foot care may be underestimated or not recognized by our patients. So a more ideally approach would be to have dedicated sessions during foot exam, and here the role of podiatry, and podiatrist is very clear for me. Coming from the University of Medicine and Pharmacy in Cluj, I can confirm that we are in good progress regarding that master in podiatry that was mentioned by President Berges. And there's an important amount of time dedicated to two modules, one for delivering general knowledge on diabetes to the future podiatrist, and another very consistent module regarding specific problems of feet in patients with diabetes. And regarding the challenges in this COVID-19 area, as Professor Bulton said, we were forced to go online, even if before we had some means to deliver online education or education done with a partner, which could be even either a site of a society like Podiatry Society, and also social media, which becomes more and more important because the accessibility to social media is larger. And but the challenge is how to distribute and share all this information, because we cannot expect that all patients with diabetes will go to the Podiatry Association site. And that's why I say that social media seems to be a more important way to deliver information and education. And the DFOOT organization is a very good resource for education material, as we will see. On the site of the Podiatry Society, there's this section where patients can find information dedicated to foot care, One of these resources is exactly a flyer, which was originally developed by DFood and then translated into Romanian, where they are taught or reminded, better said, about the most important signs of alarm when regarding to the risk of ulceration and, of course, of amputation. And this message to talk to their physician about this, because for now we don't have a podiatrist to talk to. And of course, telemedicine is a resource these days to be taken into consideration. And here we are on the Facebook with the live transmission of this event. And this morning, because I was preparing my my few words, I thought that it would be a good idea to share this education material regarding diabetic food also on the page of on the Facebook page of the Romanian Association for Diabetes Education. So hopefully more and more persons will have access to this kind of education, which is not ideal. Of course, we would prefer face-to-face encounters, individual session rather than group sessions in our in some situation, but it's a good resource, and of course we will have to develop this way of education. Thank you very much.